defined by a group of people that were born between two different time periods. In the last 125 years, there have been 8 different generations. And one of these generations was the baby boomers, or the rock and roll generation. They had the biggest increases in birth that American history has ever seen. They were known for redefining traditional values and changing culture that wasn't necessarily around beforehand. They also experienced the biggest jump in technology from the time they were born to now the world has ever seen, and they are part of that.
How does technology differ from when you were growing up to now?
When we were growing up, there was little in the way of technology. There were no cell phones, there were no computers like we have today. In fact, TV probably first came into being when I don't remember us having a TV until we were 8 or 10 years old.
Right.
And then of course we had very limited stations.
And it was black and white.
And black and white, and very limited programming, because programming would only be held, you know, certain hours of the day or evening.
And you had to have a TV antenna attached to the roof of your house.
Mm-hmm.
And in most cases, where I lived in a very rural part of the state, the TV stations that were closest to us were 90 to 100 miles away. So in lots of cases, one of the things that we had to do was turn the TV antenna in order to be able to pick up stations.
That's right.
So we had what was called a rotor that was attached to the antenna on the roof of the house, and we had a box on top of the TV, and you'd have to turn that box, you'd have to turn the antenna so that you could pick up different stations, even though you might only have 3 stations.
Do you guys were the first generation to actually have like TVs? Mm-hmm. So what type of, what did your family for a TV, did you watch it often? Did you watch the news? Did you have your own favorite TV shows?
Well, we had our own TV. Our family had our own TV. I think by the time I was 8 or 10 years old, I can't remember exactly. But there were only TV was only broadcast certain periods of time. So we didn't have TV 24 hours like it is today.
For younger kids, they mostly played outside. They played games like soccer and tag and baseball and all other things. They also played a lot of board games like checkers and chess. But as they got older, they started venturing out from home. They got driver's license and they went and hung out with friends. And when their school would hold dances, they'd go there as high schoolers. And also, a lot of people started getting TVs around this time. Some of the old people, the generation didn't have one until they were 10, but they eventually got one. But they didn't play TV 24 hours like they do now. There are only certain programs, and they'd watch the news. They also played lots of instruments and extracurricular activities that the school offered. Although they don't have all the activities we do now that require the technology we have now, they did have many of the similar activities that we do, like hanging out with friends, playing outside, and watching TV. What type of activities did you do for fun?
Well, when I was a kid, we had all kinds of kids that lived in our neighborhood. We had our own baseball diamond. We had our own hill for sliding. We had all kinds of land around our homes to do things and, you know, have fun. We did all the usual things that kids do, and we played baseball a lot. The baseball diamond was on our property just across the street from our house, and we had little parades in this little small street in back of our house, and we played musical instruments, and we did, the boys built cabins and the girls tried to find them, and
education has changed a great deal since the 50s and 60s. Then schools were segregated and you started out in first grade. There was no kindergarten. Also, the supplies used to teach students has changed since then. Back then, they used books, pens, pencils, and paper, and the teachers only had a teacher's edition and a blackboard to teach their students. Also, everything was more by the book. There were no hands-on things that students could really do, whereas now there are classes specialized in that. Students were forced to memorize the facts and really not put them into use.
My name is Edward Skanks, Jr., and I live in Buxton now, but originally I am from Jonesboro, Maine.
What was school like for you in elementary, middle, and high school?
I went to a very small school. My elementary school had grades 1 through 8. There was no kindergarten at that time. And it was a 3-room schoolhouse. And high school, all 4 grades were in one building, and we had 2 classrooms and 2 teachers. My graduating class had 6 students in it.
That's interesting.
I forgot to mention that mine had 98.
Mm-hmm. What type of activities did you do for fun?
For fun or when I was in school?
Both.
Well,
inside and outside school activities.
I don't know if you want to consider them fun, but obviously I played Little League baseball when I was growing up, and I also played basketball in high school because the school was too small to have any baseball teams or anything like that. So that was all we had in the school was basketball. I don't know if you want to consider it fun, but I swam in a granite quarry that was spring-fed for most of the summertime when I was not digging clams during the clam tide.
Well, we know as early rock and roll became very popular in the 50s and the 60s. Artists and icons like Elvis Presley, the Beach Boys, the Beatles, and Chubby Checker, who created what we know as the Twist. Popular for people around this time, but older people didn't necessarily like that. Clothing styles varied between 2 different things. You had your clothes, and then you had your school clothes, and you had your out-of-school clothes. For school, it was very different for girls in school than it was for out. In school, they were expected to wear a dress or a skirt and a blouse, with flats for shoes. But out of school, they would wear t-shirts and jeans and sneakers, just like guys would. And in school, guys wore clean shirts and clean pants and nice shoes. But out of school, their clothes might have just been a little different.
What do you think of the generation growing up now?
I think they're actually very intelligent and kind of maybe faster than we were because of the electronics, the web, you know, everything's at your fingertips. But I like the generation. I like kids.
I think it's kind of complicated, but I think they have a lot of potential. I think they need to, and I think they're very, you know, very well educated. There's a lot of very intelligent people.
There's every reason to believe that this generation could be the smartest yet because of all the technology and the things that they have exposure to that we didn't have, and the fact that they're you know, children of the global community, not just their small local community or county or state like we were when we grew up. But they're, on the other hand, their exposure to so many, many more dangerous things like drugs and alcohol and sex and, you know, all of the things that can be, you know, can harm young people, I think is very difficult.
Yes.
Yeah. Do you think you'd be a different person?
I'd be the same person that I am. Might make different choices.
No, I would not.
How come?
They're so bad.
I would hate to be a young person in today's society.
If you happen to have grown up in today's society, do you think you'd be a different person?
Probably not. If I were growing up in today's society with the same parents and the same family, I'd probably be pretty close to the same way I am now. It's because I would have had basically the same values, you know, that I currently have, and would have been brought up with the same value system. So even though, you know, the media has changed and there's a lot of things I would have been exposed to, that's the other thing that's different today than when I was growing up, is that young people are exposed to so many things at a much younger age, so many scary things at a much younger age. And so I think there's a lot more anxiety among young people today because of that, because they're exposed to so many things. And one of the things I think happens, and I've observed this, is that parents today don't shelter their kids from some of the bad things that happen, like I think we did as parents, tried to shelter our kids somewhat from some of the bad things that happened. And I know our parents did as well.